Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this random game of Dota. My name's Negative, and we'll be covering my perspective today. Now, there's a little bit of backstory to this one. I wanted to have a Spectre game. I wanted to play Spectre because the game before this, I played Spectre, and it didn't go terribly great. We got beaten pretty badly, I would say. And I wanted to play the hero. So, in this game, I was determined to have a good game. So, here I am. I picked the Spectre. I'll be going into the safe lane. And this is all pick. Now, click my viewpoint. I'm going to start off with Tango's Quelling and a Stout. I figure this is a fairly good starting build. It'll help me last hit and give me a little bit of sustain in the lane. And hopefully it goes okay. So they're still picking their heroes, and one thing you might notice is that they're fairly tanky. Now, on the way out to the rune, we're organizing who's going to go where. Now, there's a little bit of backstory. In the previous game, my previous Spectre game, the game immediately before this, I had a Rubick supporting me in lane, and he was horrible. Like, you could just tell that he was uncomfortable playing support because he had no laning presence, and I got stomped. We got stomped in lane, and nobody helped, and it ended up being really, really bad. Spectre is weak in the early game. So the reason I'm telling you that is that Rubick, okay, that Rubick that was really uncomfortable playing support is the leaner of this game. And he was going to go mid, and I was like, well, it's either going to be really, really good or really, really bad. So, yeah, they're fighting up there. That means free rune for me, which is good. Gets me halfway to level 2, straight off the bat. And everyone escapes without too much damage done. So, something you'll notice is that their heroes are pretty tanky. The Sand King, Huskar, and Wraith King are all strength-based heroes. And then you've got the Slark, which I'm pretty much never going to be able to kill because it's a Slark. Like, how does a Spectre kill a Slark? I have no lockdown, I have no stuns. Unless I just happen to right-click him at the right time, I'm not going to kill that guy. So anyway, it turns out I'm going to be fighting with the Lifestealer for last hits. We get ravaged by the Sand King. So it looks like we're going to go ham a little bit here. So I throw out a dagger, try and slow the Slark down. The Lifestealer just throws his life away, and I have to be careful here. I get stunned, so, you know, whatever. The Slark starts to salve up, so I'm just going to see if I can get away. The Lifestealer's back already, and he's going to get right in that. I get pounced. I don't think I was being aimed at, and the stuns just keep coming. This guy surely has no mana now. Luckily, I'm going to make it back to the tower. I'll lead a tango. And this is not how the early game should go for a Spectre. This is not what I want right now. And I wanted to cover this game because it was a hard game. I really, really thought that, you know, it was a rough game. Just going to eat another tango, try and get back to full health. The Lifestealer's madly pushing the wave. You know, whatever. He does a lot of damage, but, you know, I'm a Spectre, you know, I need to farm up. If I don't get farm, I have no impact on the game whatsoever. And you'll notice that the Spectre is actually less net worth than I am right now. And that's because he died, I think. Now, I've leveled Desolate, I've leveled Dagger. The Sand King has Ace, so he pokes me a little bit. And he actually could have chased me a little bit more there, I think. The Lifestealer does come back, so that's kind of scares him off a bit, I think. So, yeah, rough lane, and it's going to be a rough game, too. You know, there's no real squishy supports. The Sand King kind of just, he's not worried. He outplays us a little bit there. I still haven't got a last hit. It's 3 minutes in. And at this stage, I'm just kind of like, well, what am I supposed to do here? You know, I'm a Spectre. Like, I noticed that the Sand King comes out of Sandstorm. We spot him here. And the Lifestealer actually lets him pass. I get the Spectral Dagger down to try and get the free pathing. Go straight through the trees. And unlucky, we can't get him. I didn't actually manage to target him. If I had managed to target him, we would have been in a much better spot. You can see that I've fallen down the net worth charts, and I'm a long way from where I'd really like to be. So, being behind as a Spectre is really, really bad news. You do not want to be behind. Because you just have so few tools to catch up. Now, I can't stand in that, because I have no lifesteal, but the lifesteal is pretty tough, and he's just going to stand in there and wallop creeps. And I'm pinging out for him to try and deny some of these. It's fairly easy in Sandstorm, but he doesn't. And, anyway. This is the offlane against Sand King. So I punch this guy a little bit. He pounces away. That's fine. That's burning mana. And again, this guy's pushing the lane as hard as he can. I have no idea why. And I'm at the bottom of the net worth charts, so happy days for a Spectre. And I don't know what the Lifestealer is thinking, to be honest, because it's not like he carries harder than me. So this guy completely whiffs his pounce. Turns out there's an invis. There's an invis, what's his face? Invis Sand King hanging around, and we actually get a kill. Simply because the Lifestealer just destroys the Slark. You know, had he connected on that pounce, he would have done bonus damage to me, and probably would have been a worse situation for me. Right now, I'm just trying to find somewhere to farm. Getting that kill really helps. But I'm still really behind. You see, I'm a level 4 Spectre. Lifestealer's 5. The Slark and the Sand King are both 5. The Slark's got 11 last hits at this stage. The Lifestealer gets jumped on. I can't really do much. I don't have any mana. And the Earth Shaker actually blocks him out. Now, right now, I probably should have went back to base. I elect to hide in the trees, which I don't think is the right choice here. The Earthshaker, no idea what he was doing, but he feeds a killer as well. So the Huskar's having, you know, fun times early game. 2 kills. And this is kind of a common occurrence for the early game. You know, the safe lane is not safe. So the Huskar roams on the bottom lane at 6 minutes, gets 2 kills out of it. But that's pretty bad news, because, you know, the Lifestealer had been the one that was farming. It wasn't me, it was him. Luckily, the Lina picks up the kill on the Huskar. You know, that heavy nuke damage from the Lina does offset some of the strengths of the Huskar, insofar as that he attacks really fast when he's at low health, and you know, the Lina can just ball straight through that. So we stun him out of it. Now, I forget that I have free pathing, so I go to walk around the Fissure. Possibly a mistake, but you know, is what it is. And I cliff myself here. I was just about to call for some help, and then I realized that I had a Quelling Blade, so I just quelled myself out of there and go back to not getting any farm. I have 4 last hits, though. There's lots of heroes down here again. So this is 7.5 minutes. I'm going to join in here and punch what I can. So there's very little I can do, though. I'm a level 4 Spectre, remember? And jumping in there against 3 heroes? Bad news bears. So that's another 2 kills. We don't have any rotations from the Lina. You can see them trying to find me. But, You know, I know exactly how squishy I am right now, and I don't want any part of getting involved with that. And, you know, I'm pinging out the leaner, saying, look, come on, get it. I get pounced here, and it's probably pretty bad. Luckily, the Earthshaker rocks up at the exact right moment and saves my ass. That Earthshaker, he makes some really dumb plays in the early game, but he also makes some really good ones, and that's one of the really good ones. You know, I was dead there. I was dead, and that would have taken my situation from extremely bad to catastrophic. You know, had I died there, you know, that's just so bad. I have to go back to base, though, because I just have no health, and it's going to take me forever to regen up. The Huskar jumps on the leaner. The leaner gets the stun, but she's going to tick down to the burning stacks, unfortunately. So it's a bit of a one-for-one. So I'm going to grab a TP. The Lifestealer has started to jungle. He doesn't have an Iron Talon, which, you know, is perplexing for a hero that is quite good at jungling. I wouldn't say he's amazing, but he's quite good at jungling. And I want to point something out here. The Earthshaker has put up two wards right now. I'll just take a... You see, he's put up a ward here and here. So this is, you know, two really good spots. I can see what's coming, and I can see what's happening in this area. So Lifestealer's going to jump on that. He's going to pounce away. You know, is what it is. So I'm going to dagger the Sand King. He goes into Sandstorm. I'm going to run away. I'm pinging the leaner, Satan, stun him out of it. He gets the stun on, and what I'm trying to do right now is just hang around so that I get experience. Because I'm level 5, and you'll notice that both the Sand King and the Slark are level 6. So I am massively behind right now. Massively behind. But I hang around, I help get the assist, I get some experience out of it, and I can start farming, finally. It's 10 minutes in and I have a ring of health. A ring of health and some claws. What are these called? Blades of attack. Some blades of attack. Not where Spectre wants to be. By 10 minutes, you really want to have phase boots. This guy just tries to stun me. Goes into a sandstorm. I can see the Slark over there. And these guys are just trying to run at me, and it's annoying, but it's exactly what they should be doing. And right now, I'm pinging him out, calling for help. You know, any kind of rotation. If the, you know, the Legion Commander, she's got 6 right now, and I'm saying to her, if you come down here, there's free duels. I'll just bait them in. They'll jump on me, and she can duel them. But unfortunately, I am left to my own devices, and, you know, this is really not what you want as a Spectre. I'm going to dagger out here. It's unlikely that they dive me under my own tower. So I'm just going to do what I can to farm, hold the tower as long as I can, because it gives me somewhere to farm. I'm still calling for help through all of this. And the Lina finally lobs up. So she'll stun the Sand King, but he's going to have Burrow Strike. I'll get the dagger onto him. I'm going to haunt after him, see if I can do something here. Unfortunately, he's just too fast. I don't have boots yet. Meanwhile, the Huskar picks off the Lifestealer in the jungle. He was just AFK farming and gets killed for his crimes. And again, there's all these heroes just in the bottom lane. They're just coming. I don't know if they think that they're getting something done down here, but, you know, basically it's just terrible. I get an assist there. And it's starting to look really... it's not looking really good, but it's looking better. You know, I've overtaken the Lifestealer, who was insistent on taking all the farm. I couldn't outlast hit him if I tried. I got to return to base here, just heal up, get some more mana. I have my phase boots, which is good. The phase boots plus spectral dagger means I've got a lot of chase. I'm going to grab a Sage's Mask just to try and boost my mana regen a little bit. I'm going to sell the Gauntlet of Strength, because I don't need that quite at the moment. I need some way of TPing back to lane. Someone dropped their boots. And the Lifestealer is just going to go ham right now. And right now, I should be TPing in. I'm not. But I TP in now. Turns out there was nothing that I could do because the Huskar was there. Now, if the Huskar goes in, well, he does go in. So I dagger him, and we get a kill on him, which is quite quite handy. You know, I've got 4 assists, 1 kill, no deaths. I think that I'm really making the most of this this situation. The laner just nukes the wave. Yep, no worries, no farm for me. Oh god, it's so rough. I'm just getting nothing. Like, and this is partly why I wanted to show you guys. You know, the way I recover, I want to see what you guys think about how I recovered and how I went about to trying to have an impact in this game. Anyway, I'm going to return to lane right now. The lane is pushing in, so that means I can farm this. And right now, what I'm aiming to do is I'm aiming to get my urn, okay? And then I want to finish off my vanguard. The decision here was to build urn to help with mana, and then build the vanguard just to help me fight. If I had free farm down here, I would have probably went drums. Drums is really good if you're fighting early. And right now, this moment, okay, this is minute 15. Again, 3 fucking heroes in our jungle looking for me. He has a DD. They're just looking for fucking people. And I can't believe this at this point in time. I'm just like, oh my god. So I'm in the fucking trees. I'm like, screw this, guys. I'm not standing out there. I'm telling my team. And they're like, yeah, hide. So I don't... I think that this is actually where Earthshaker keeps us in the game, okay? Those two wards, I see those rotations. I actually haunt to the top lane, right? I'm telling my team, right, they're all fucking bottom. We need to kill these nerds. So I get up here, and it turns it from a 3v2 into a 4v2. We get the duel. We get the win. And that is the strength of Spectre, I think. You know, I can come from the bottom lane all the way from the trees behind the tier 1 tower to the top lane and help get my team get 2 kills. So I was quite proud of that little rotation and quite proud of my team because they did pull it off. Right now they're going to take our tier 1 and then TP top immediately. I'm going to finish my urn. She's going to give me a little bit of mana regen. You know, tank me up a little bit as well. See, there's 3 heroes in the top lane. They are just hugging butt right now. And it's extremely annoying. So I get a dagger on him. Just to see if he's going to jump in. I'm trying to bait him. Trying to bait the jump. Because there's 5 heroes top now. And this is, yeah, interesting. Looks like old mate is going to do the same. Misses stun. Meanwhile, the Zeus nukes us down, and people are just falling left, right, and center. Now, at this point, I should be running. I get stunned by the Wraith King somehow. The range is absolute bullshit. They chain up some control, and it turns into a 4 kill. So, that's what happens when no one jumps, and the Lifestealer is still just AFK jungling. And right now, I'm telling him to get out. I'm telling him to kill that nerd or get out. Luckily, the Zeus's skill build is weird. Top tower is it's a good thing he didn't max the W. Otherwise, he probably would have killed someone outright. It looks like he is just going to jump in on the Zeus. And he will kill him. So, I have Haunter right now. And that's probably what I should do. So, we're going to Haunt after the Sand King, and unfortunately can't get him. The Wraith King turns around and uses his one spell to stop me from chasing. Anyway, I'm going to max Desolate here. If I was a little bit faster on that, possibly could have got to the Slark, but that's fine. And we also pick up the Sand King, so that's a five wipe in the other direction. And No, at this stage, I've got 3 kills, 1 death, 9 assists. I'm not happy, but I'm happy, you know. The Zeus throws out a random ulti to try and, I don't know, kill someone, I assume. I finish up my Vanguard, that's going to tank me up a little bit. Going to help me survive against a lot of the shit that's flying around. I'm going to buy a quick wand. Again, more sustain. I'm trying to ensure that I don't die. That's what I'm trying to do. They take the top tower, and I'm here just farming away. Because now I need to start working towards my Radiance, and that's going to take some time. You know, Spectre doesn't farm the fastest. You know, she's not like a, you know, say a Sven that has that natural cleave, or Slark who has Dark Pact and who can regen in between camps. You know, I'm pretty much on my own when it comes to doing stuff. Earthshake is going to drop down a stun. I'm going to path down, path back up. See if I can bait something in. Because now I've got my urn, I can deal a fair bit of pure damage. If I use this offensively, I can, what is it? Enemy total damage, 150 pure damage. That's on top of Desolate, my right clicks, and the magical damage of Dagger. So I'm just going to Dagger in here, just to add as much damage quickly as I can. Now, I wasn't sure if he was going to actually get the win there. So I'm just going to push this lane a little bit. He's going to dive on me, which is fine, because I've got my team backing me up. Echo Slam goes down. I get killed. You know, them's the breaks. I'm always going to attract a lot of attention in fights because I am a Spectre. And at this particular point in time, you know, we're just fighting all over the map. You can see we've got a net worth advantage, and that's because we're continuing to farm. I'm hitting creeps. The Lina's trying to hit some creeps. The Lifestealer's hitting creeps. The Legion's hitting creeps. So we are still trying to keep farming, which is very important. And something about the Dire, the Zeus doesn't really farm very much. And I think that starts to really tell, because he can deal a lot of damage, especially to me. I'm not a natural BKB carrier. I don't really want to buy BKB. I want to buy Radiance. I want to buy, you know, Diffusal Blade. I want to buy, you know, kind of these offensive items. A BKB isn't really what Spectre wants to buy. Anyway, so they're hugging butt in our jungle again, behind our tier 1. And I'm like, well, I don't really want to go in on this, so I send in a dagger and actually get a kill on the Slark. And I'm pretty happy about this, so I'm just going to back off, because I don't really want to be in there, you know, alone v a couple of heroes. You know, I can certainly fight, I've got Haunt up, but I'm not really dealing that much damage right now. You know, I'm more being annoying. So I'm going to get a dagger on this bloke, use the urn, going to get a stun down. We're going to pop his reincarnation, which is fine. I'm happy to walk away here, except the old mate's going to get stunned up, and, well, that's that. The Zeus tries to kill steal again. I'm going to haunt forward, or try to haunt forward. It doesn't work out because I'm not quick enough, and, you know, that's something that takes a bit of practice. And here the Sand King just burrow strikes, sandstorms. Burrow strikes, sandstorms. Because we have no support, we have no detection, and we're not killing him. Now, the Wraith King has gone for a Battle Fury. You may have noticed the cleave there, and, well, Battle Fury makes Wraith King a very squishy boy. The Lina lays down the Laguna Blade, and I dagger to get the kill. So right now, I'm just looking for somewhere to farm. I decide to go back to base to get mana, or do I?
Thank you.
Actually, the Earthshaker had boots, and I asked him to wait, and he didn't. So now I'm like, well, what do I do? So I'm going to hit creeps. I actually use my wand to get some mana so I can keep going. I notice that here in the mid lane, they're trying to push again. So I'm going to dagger the Zeus. They're going to take the tower. There's nothing I can do to stop it. I'm a Spectre. And it's early game and I have no items. And this guy is extremely annoying. You know, he's going to get stunned out of it. He blinks away. The Lena didn't think to Dragon Slave him first. Didn't know he had a blink, I don't think, at that stage. So at this stage, I'm starting to catch up on net worth. There's no way an Earthshaker out. He last hits me with Quelling and Desolate. So right now, I'm trying to work towards... this is Zeus, right? He's just trying to kill steal. So I'm going to fucking make sure he works for his... works for his kill stealing. And he didn't get it either, by the way. He does that every single time. And this is the thing about Zeus. You shouldn't be using your ulti to kill steal. You should be using your ulti to turn fights and help your teammates. You know, with solo pickups like that. It's like, I have no haunt, so I can't join them fast here. And I realized that was probably a little bit of a mistake using it before. But my team are going to be able to defend that tower. And right now, I feel... It feels like we're just up against the wall. Like we're being pressed so hard by these guys. They're just pushing. They're hugging butt and pushing as hard as they can. And it's giving me, you know, very little space to farm. And I notice that the Zeus just wanders into this bottom lane. I'm like, well, he just TP'd, so his TP's on cooldown. I wonder if he's still here. Lo and behold, he's just wandering through the river. Oh, yes, I am in that ass. And right now, I'm like, yes, Zeusy, come here, my boy. Come here, Zeus, no TP for you. And I also know that everyone is in the top lane. So I just need to right-click him. And, yeah, that's... I give him a good game, well played, because a good game, well played him when he TP'd out, because that kind of play is very smart. I'm a Spectre. I can't stop him from TPing out. I have no interrupts. Anyway, my team is feeding in the top lane, which is great news. So I'm like, well, looks like I'm back to farming. I'm going to dagger as much as I can here. Just do damage. You know, my dispersion is going to return a lot of the damage, and the Vanguard's going to do a lot of work as well. So I'm on top of the network right now. I'm farming away reasonably well. I would say reasonably well. Radiant structures are fortified. Right now I have a TP, so I can TP to the top lane. But I don't really have much mana. That's the only issue. So I'm going to return to base here. Get some mana and then probably haunt in. I decide to TP out to get mana quickly so I can haunt in. Turns out my team aren't looking to fight. And this I think is the power of Spectre, is that you can be somewhere. You can be anywhere on the map. You can be farming, having a merry old time. Fight goes down, you press R, you join the fight. And it's not like Zeus. So you see here, I join the fight and I go after the Wraith King. Because this guy's tanky, right? And I know that we need to do what we can. Managed to get him pop his, what's his face? I managed to get just to the high ground, which completely fucks any chance of him chasing me. And, you know, I think that's probably worth it. Because at this stage, he is level 14. Which is probably a level 2 ulti, I would say, from the Wraith King. But that's still a relatively long cooldown. That's 160 seconds. So, you know, I think that that's probably worth it. He needs to be a little bit more careful with where he goes. He can't just dive in anywhere. Right now, I see the Huskar, so I'm going to dagger. Turns out the Lina's just going to nuke the shit out of him. I'm going to get the pure damage on. The stun comes through from the Lina, and she gets a double kill. So, good stuff right now. We're managing to hold our own. That's the most important thing. I'm making progress on my Radiance. The Lina has 15 kills. She's having a whale of a time. I'm going to go back to this bottom lane, farm this up. Plenty of farm to be had down here. It's really, really good. And I managed to get one before the Lina nukes it in. You know, what am I? I'm 1,000 gold away from my Radiance. It's a very slow Radiance timing, I know, because it's 27 minutes in. But at this stage, I need to just do what I can to get it. Once I got my Radiance, we should be right. So I'm going to dagger this guy and go after him. Because he's warding our jungle. Anything I can do to force him out is good news. I get pounced on by the Slark, that's fine. He doesn't really do enough damage. And then the Wraith King lobs up from fucking who knows where. And I'm going to do what I can to get out of there. I actually fall to the Caustic Finale. We're actually going to get a triple kill out of it, so it's probably worth it. Oh, here comes the Husker. He wants some too. Echo Slam ends up being 4 kills out of that. So I'm like, well, that's worth it. You know, I probably could have lived there had I had the presence of mind to click my wand. But I didn't, so I die. I am, you know, still not the best at Dota. But I've only had 3 kills, which I'm pretty happy about. I'm happy about the fact that I'm not dying, but I'm still having, you know, some impact on the fights. I'm being able to... I'm showing up still. And this game is pretty close. And I think it's about... It's in this kind of phase right now that we start to come back. The Lifestealer finds the Zeus, and again, the TP out. He'll make it. And again, good game, well played. Like, that kind of play is heads up. Because if he doesn't TP, he dies. You know, TPing is the only way he lives in those situations. That moment when Slark has more dual damage than Legion Commander, yep. So, you know, that's the other thing right now. Our Legion Commander isn't having a great game, and our Lifestealer isn't the best on the hero. The Earthshaker, he's doing what he can to stun people. It's pretty rough, you know. Right now I'm going to dagger, try and do as much damage, try and get as much of this farm as I can. I do get a good percentage of it. I could be more effective with how much of those last hits I get. But anyway. So right now the Lifestealer is in their jungle. I managed to pull the creep wave away from the Lina so she can't nuke it. Hopefully means I get some last hits here. I was really bad at last hitting this game, just by the way. Where's the... So the Slark, like, the Lifestealer is in their jungle. And I'm like, you clown, like, they're all there. I've got Haunt, if I need it. It looks like this guy's got a Helm of the Dominator with a what's-his-face. So I'm going to Haunt in. I'm going to go after Zeus because he's nice and squishy. So I did get the double kill there. I'm like, stun him out of it, fuck's sake. And then he blinked. So we lost. But the good news is I have my Radiance. And a 31 minute Radiance is bad. I think generally you want it by kind of 25 minutes. I think. You know, you go 25 minutes... Drums, Urn, Phase. You know, admittedly, I stopped off for the Vanguard as well. Which probably slowed down that timing, if anything. But right now, we're going to... we're really going to start to come online. And now it's a question of, what do I want next? Because I'm about to really start to farm fast as well. This is the other thing. With Radiance, I can farm so much faster. You know, up till now, it's been a bit of a grind. And now I get to... have a bit of fun. So the Wraith King blinks out before my Radiance damage can actually get to him. Which is a shame. But, you know, is what it is. Right now, I can see the path. So I'm like, well, that's into the darkness. And I don't really want to go there without support. Because I don't know how many of their heroes are around. As you can see, 3 in the top. And the Wraith King is actually farming our jungle. So I'm like, well, I know he's in there. I'm not really too worried about him, so I'm just going to farm this. I'm like, right, I'll farm this jungle. I didn't know the Wraith King was like had hung around so long. So I'm like, well, maybe I'll push this line. And I'm starting to get some more gold together, which is good. The bonus damage from Desolate is just huge. You know, 65 bonus damage plus the, you know, 170 I already do. You know, I'm starting to deal some damage, and I think it's more a their team makeup, they're very, very tanky. Like, their team is very, very tanky. Right now, I don't particularly want to get into a skirmish on this. I see the Sand King in the river, well, I'm like, wow, let's do this. Right now, he is getting hit by the Radiance Burn damage and the Slark Shadow Blades in onto me. So right now, I'm just like, well, fuck you guys, I'm going out. And I'm going back in. And, you know, the Radiance is doing its thing. Right now, I'm in a fair amount of trouble. I've been slowed by something. I don't know what. Anyway, the urn is great because it allows me to do this, right? So I can go back, I can heal. And then I can re-engage. I still have Haunt, by the way. And now I'm like, well, I just want to tank up. I want to make sure that I don't die. If I don't die, I can keep going on, dealing damage. I Haunt in here, trying to create some space so that we can, you know, try and get a kill or two. But no one's hanging around. Which is a bit of a bugger, really. So I'm going to heal myself with my last urn charge. If someone dies around me when I have zero urn charges, it's better. Because this way I will get two charges. And we actually get that second tower there, so that's really good. And I'm picking my team to get back, get out. We don't want to hang around. And I find a Wraith King. I'm like, guys, help, please. Help, please. And this Earthshaker, you know, he messed up his... And right now, I'm like, come on, guys, let's go. And, like, my team just don't follow me. I'm like, well, fuck. You know, what am I supposed to do here? It's going to be an... interrupted ulti from the Sand King. I'm hanging around a little bit. I am getting low. I'm going to dagger over the edge and manage to escape. The Huskar is there. I'm going to heal. And I'm going to try and back off just so I can get some more health together. Luckily, I dodged the Zeus ult because I did use the urn on myself. I'm going to hang around here and farm this wave because they're all dead. What's the Zeus going to do? So happy days, I've got my vitality booster as well, so I'm starting to get really, really fat. And, you know, the Zeus rocks up, I'm like, please, Zeus, please, Zeus, please. I'm like, look, man, I'm not dying to you, fuck off. You know, I have quite an extreme mobility advantage over a hero like Zeus, especially, see, I give him the please, Zeus, please. I'm just trying to farm, and... he's there trying to kill me. I'm like, come on, bro. You're not going to kill me. So I'm going to sell this. Grab my Reaver. I am really tanky now. This plus the Urn, plus the Radiance, plus the Vanguard. You know, I'm really starting to pile on the tank. And this was the plan. I want to be able to live through these fights. You see, the Lina is having a really good game. And I think that's one of the things that made this so interesting. Is because the previous Spectre game was so bad because of... you know, his uncomfortableness on support. You know, seems that when he plays Gary, no such worries. So I've got, 1,000 gold to go until my heart. Once I've got the heart, then I can start looking at other options. You know, trying to increase my damage is the plan from here. Gonna dagger in. I've got plenty of mana at this stage. I'm, you know, regenning at a nice rate, 3.6 per second, so... I'm not having mana problems, and I'm going to see if I can get across here to try and help my team. I Haunt in. I get a dagger onto one. Do some damage to the Sand King. And the Lina nukes the Huskar. So that's a 2-for-1 trade. And again, they're starting to really have some problems pushing. You know, I'm showing up to fights, and I'm dealing damage. The Lina is just blowing people up left, right, and center. So it's... this game is really starting to come back to a place where we want it. You know, our XP is in front, our net worth is in front. The game is hard right now for the Dire. Right now, I'm just going to try and draw as much of this as I can. And oh my god, the farm. That was like probably... it's probably what? 300-400 gold there? And happy days. That's my heart finished. And then there's another wave. I'm like, oh, the dream. The dream is a Spectre. Just to sit in waves and Radiance burn them down. I'm also starting to get some good levels as well. You know, I'm level 22. I'm out-leveling every single one of their team. I'm out-leveling the leaner. This is the beauty of staying alive. Because I haven't died, I'm just banking that experience. You know, there's never any time where I'm off the map. Radiant's top tower is under attack. And this guy's getting killed. I'm like, well, I can't help you. I don't have a TP. I don't have Haunt. You know, you're on your own. And somehow he actually gets away from him. I'm like, all right, dude, run to me. I'm like, run to me. Because I know that, you know, if I'm around, it's less likely that they're able to kill him. Or if they are going to kill him, I'm going to kill them. This guy burrow strikes in and then gets out again. I'm trying to do some damage here. And I'm like, well, fucking bring it. I have my heart. Let's see what you got, Wraith Gang. Right now, I'm battling three heroes, right? So I'm like, well, this is probably not the best. Maybe I need to back up a little bit. I get slowed by the caustic finale. I get pounced again. But you can see how long it's taking them to kill me. And all this while, I'm dealing radiance damage. I've got the haunt. Not the haunt, the dagger going. Or I had the dagger going early. And I used the urn to heal me here. And that was a mistake because the Heart of Taras kind of regens you really quick if you just let it. Anyway. So right now, I'm going to actually finish up a Crimson Guard here. I just want to be tanky. And I've got the Vanguard there, so I may as well just complete it. Get a dagger through. Get as much as I can. And as I said before, my last hitting this game was horrible. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower has fallen. So right now, I have 3,000 hit points. You know, that's a lot of health. And something interesting, actually, about the Slark is that I'm not really worried about him. Like, Essence Shift doesn't really hurt me as much as it would other carries, I don't think. Because I'm not really relying on my attributes to deal damage. I'm relying on my skills. I'm relying on the Radiance. So, you know, he can steal those attributes, and it doesn't hurt me so much. Of course, it buffs him heaps. Like, getting three agi per thing is incredible. And right now, you can actually see on the screen the effect of him under Shadow Blade. I'm just like, guys, I'm farming the lane. I know I've got support here. So I know that I can push this pretty safely. The leaner's backing me up. You know, I know there's one showing in the bottom lane. I'm just like, you know, whatever, guys. I'm going to push this lane. It's going to get stunned out of that. The leaner's going to get nuked. I'm going to haunt and see if I can get the Zeus here. And it turns out I actually kill the Sand King. And this guy, I'm like, well, bring it. And right now, they're all jumping on me, so I'm calling to my team. I'm like, guys, help. And I managed to kill one of them, and the Lifestealer is just fucking AFK farming the jungle this entire time. It's like, oh my god. It's absolutely incredible. They do finally show up. So it's, you know, it's one of those things where you're like, well, I'm glad that you got there, but I didn't have to die. If, you know, they had had the presence of mind to actually, you know, show up to the fight when the fight was going down, it would have been much better. The Earthshaker, you know, again, he's just going to go ham here. And you can tell he's a very new player. Because he's like, I'm like, don't, dude, you're going to die. And he died. It's like, seriously, man, you don't need to do that. Like, we're winning the game. Don't do it. Right now, the Lifestealer's just going to go ham on him. He gets a lucky bash. And he's going to Blink Strike away. Ah, damn. The fun in the games, you know. It's absolutely hilarious. So right now, I've got my Yasha. I'm going to start working towards a Manta style. You know, try and get that damage. And also become a little bit safer with how I'm doing things, because right now I'm having to push personally. Once I've got a Manta, I've got illusions, and I can send my illusions to push waves, and I don't have to be standing there on the front lines, because, you know, they are going to jump on me. They're going to try and chain stun me, and that's just not fun when you're chain stunned. You know, you're just taking your hands off the keyboard. Oh, the other advantage of the Manta style, it gives me attack speed, movement speed, bit of agility, you know, and some stats. So, you know, I really didn't think there was anything bad about doing this. I figured that it was, you know, it was fitting in with that whole, you know, tank up, get some stats. I'm going to haunt in here on the Wraith King because I know he's alone. And we're just going to do big damage to him. He's got his what's-its-face, which is fine. Because we're just going to absolutely blow him up. And again, the power of Spectre. You know, I'm able to be farming our jungle and then show up in their top lane. Or both. It's both teams' top lane, really. And, you know, blow up their carry. It's very, very strong, that global presence. I think it's even stronger than Zeus's. Because Zeus, you press R and that's all the global presence that you have. With Spectre, you press R, you show up, and then you start dealing damage. Like, the initial R press does deal damage, because obviously you're dealing Desolate, your Radiant's burning them. But, you know, when you start right-clicking people, when you dagger after people, that's when it, you know, you really start to have an impact on a fight. You know, if Zeus is on the other side of the map, all he can do is press R, and then that's it. And anyway, I'm pinging this guy. We get a duel on him, which is good. So we've got control. Means we can just plow into him. He's very, very tanky at this stage. And the Lifestealer actually picks up the Zeus somewhere. So right now, we're starting to really get in front. I sell my TP to pick up an ultimate orb. And then I put a TP on the courier. So I can still have that transport if I need it. I'm going to push this wave real quick. So there's three dead. I probably should be pushing with my team, but, you know, mistakes were made. Right now, you can see I'm on top of the net worth by a clear 2,000. So I'm going to push this. I know that there's only two up, and they're showing middle and top, so that means I can push this relatively safely. I get my Manta, which is great. I can start to using illusions. You know, at this stage, I'm feeling pretty good about the game. It's not a sure win, for sure. But we're starting to, you know, really make some progress. And I'm wanting to go in on this guy. Because he's really squishy. And I know that we can get a kill here. Unluckily, we do get him. And I'm like, yep, well, that'll do. I'm out. And the Lifestealer actually gets stuck. So I couldn't have we couldn't have popped him without the Lifestealer, and unfortunately I just had to abandon him. There's no way I do anything there. So I'm going to Manta, A-click the enemy fountain, and they'll push the wave for me. Right now I'm going to show back up to the fight. And he knows he's in trouble. I'll get a dagger on him, the stun, Laguna Blade. We're just pouring the damage on, but he's so tanky. So tanky. So you can see that the noose has tightened somewhat. You know, we're on their third of the map. We're, you know, trying to keep all the lanes pushed, or I'm trying to keep all the lanes pushed. Again, Manta up, A-click the enemy fountain. They'll push the lane. I'm picking this guy, expecting someone to blink on him. Way too slow. You know, if someone gives me vision, I can do something. Right now, I'm getting focused pretty hard. There's, you know, two, three heroes on me. So I'm like, well, I need to back the fuck up. And I will actually die here. But I'm like, well, this is a pretty pivotal fight. So I'm going to buy back, port the fuck back in, and I'm going to kill everyone. Dyer's middle barracks are under attack. You know, and this is why I wanted to do that. because I knew that by buying back in, I could force Rax here. And we're having trouble breaking the high ground. Right now, I don't know what my team are doing. They're just, you know, off AFK farming the jungle. Rather than pushing buildings. Like, I just don't know. Right now, I'm trying to do my best to hit buildings, to do stuff. He pounces away, so I know I'm not going to get him. And thankfully, the Legion Commander shows up. So he wants to stand around and punch me. I'm going to punch him back. We're just going to make sure these lanes are pushed, and then we're going to retreat. I'm picking my team to get back, because, you know, we don't want to be going in here. The Lifestealer picks up the Huskar somehow. And things are starting to look better for us. So I'm just going to go grab this this bottom lane now. Make sure it stays pushed. And my team, meanwhile, decide to fight in their base. Because, you know, that's naturally what you want to do when there's only two of you still alive. And this actually, you know, made me a happy boy. Look at all that. I was like, oh my god, let me at it. That was a big wave, you know. And that was pushing pretty hard, so that was going to, you know, probably take our bottom tower. But Spectre says no. We'll farm that up. It's amazing that the Lifestealer has stayed so close to me. In net worth, that is. So, Mander up, A-click the enemy fountain. They'll push that bottom lane for us. I'm going to try and get in here on the bottom lane. Help my team out. Jewel goes down on the Sand King, which is about perfect. I'll ping him out. Alright, and the pain starts to come in. Stun, and yeah, easy win. So right now, it's time to hit buildings. I'm picking it out to my team. But they're pushing the middle lane for some reason. I'm like, oh my god. Just fucking hit the towers, please. So, you know, I don't think that we can end, because their characters are really, really strong. So, I'm going to do what I can to make sure my team wins the game. I'm going to hit barracks. So we've got two lanes now. I'm feeling pretty good about the game. You know, we're a long way in front. We've got barracks gold. We've got, you know, a bit of an advantage with me. You know, I'm probably more of a late game carry than anyone else on their team. So I'm going to TP back right now. Just heal up. I'm going to sell my phase boots. Get my TP boots. And I have haunt. So I'm going to haunt the fuck back in. And this guy, I'm like, right, you are mine. Unfortunately, I fuck up my illusions. They had started attacking the wave. And right now, I'm just going ham on this bloke. So there's Radiance damage. I'm right-clicking him with Desolate. BKBs. And he just fucking walks it off. I'm like, holy shit. You know, that impressed me. You know, he did really well. The BKB, I think, actually stopped the Radiance damage, which allowed him to armlet through. So now all we need to do is take the bottom lane. Anyway, it's happening in the mid lane. I'm getting in there. I'm going to hit the Wraith King as well, because he's a little bit squishier. And then I'm like, ooh, Zeus. And then they do a lot of damage. No, I lose half my health points. I'm just going to back up, regen up. I notice somewhere in here that my Radiance is actually turned off, which is a bit of a mistake. The Lifestealer gets the Abyssal on the old mate. They hit him with the Shiva's Guard, the Bash. He's going to regen. He's going to... What's his face? I manned her up to really put the pain on, and you see he just explodes. So all we have to do is push one more lane. One more lane. That's all we have to do. The Legion's going to buy back, which is probably a good thing. The Slark misses his pounce and gets absolutely exploded by the Lina. I'm like, well, let's do it. Let's take the final lane. Let's win this game. It's been a hard game. And yeah, that's Mega Creep. So this game is over. Got a mana up to try and blow up the Wraith King. I do manage to kill him. And that is the game. I actually don't realise that the Radiance is turned off. Huh. Ah, now I realise. Nearly get the kill there. But that was the Spectre game. And I felt that, you know, I did pretty well. I think that overall, with the start that I had, and the effect that I was able to have in the end, you know, I think that was a good game for me. So I hope that you've enjoyed this replay commentary, and I look forward to seeing you around next time.